When Bruno first approached the boy, he was sitting cross-legged on the ground, staring at the dust beneath him. However, after a moment, he looked up and Bruno saw his face. It was quite a strange face, too. His skin was almost the color of gray, but not quite like any gray that Bruno had ever seen before. He had very large eyes, and they were the color of caramel sweets. The whites were very white, and when the boy looked at him, all Bruno could see was an enormous pair of sad eyes staring back. Bruno was sure that he had never seen a skinnier or sadder boy in his life, but decided that he had better talk to him.
I've been exploring.
Have you?
Yes, for almost 2 hours now.
Have you found anything?
Very little.
Nothing at all?
Well, I found you. He stared at the boy and considered asking him why he looked so sad, but hesitated because he thought it might sound rude. He knew that sometimes people who were sad didn't want to be asked about it. Sometimes they'd offer up the information themselves, and sometimes they wouldn't stop talking about it for months on end. But on this occasion, Bruno thought that he should wait before saying anything. He had discovered something during his exploration, and now that he was finally talking to one of the people on the other side of the fence, it seemed like a good idea to make the most of the opportunity.